Welcome to the One Minute Apologists. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
So how does the Quran compare to the Bible?
Well, the Bible is actually two sections. It's the Old Testament and the New Testament, and composed of 66 books. And so the Quran is very different in that it's not an anthology of books, for one. But also, if you think about the Bible, generally you'll think about a gospel, say the Gospel of Matthew, which was written by one person from beginning to end, probably in one go. The Quran is not like that. The Quran was composed in snippets by being dictated by Muhammad. So he had short sections that he would give to Muslims. And after he died, all those sections were brought together. Now, the word for recitation in Arabic at that time was Quran. And so the recitations that he recited were all put together in one book after he died, and that one book was called the Quran, or all the recitations in one. So oftentimes people try to read the Quran as they read the Bible from beginning to end, assuming it to be one story or a set of laws that are meant to read that way. They're not. They were all individual sections. There is no complete story apart from one in the Quran. All the stories either begin in the middle and end, or they begin at the beginning and don't get to the end. The Quran is very different in many different ways, and we should remember that when we're thinking about comparing the Quran and the Bible.